another fantastic adventure about to begin today in North Texas. We're going to hook up again with Jimmy D, Davis Guide Service, on a lake about 2 hours from Dallas, called Lake Whitney. And James tells us we're going to do some stuff similar that we've done before in Texas for this time of the year, vertical jigging in some timber, some deeper structure and stuff, long poles and plastics, hair jigs and stuff, but just giving an example and some variety of the different lakes and the options that are available here in Texas. It's just countless. The amount of guides, the amount of opportunities and locations, it's just mind-boggling, man. But boy, what a place for crappie. So I don't know if it's going to be white crappie, black crappie, but hey, as long as it's those big fat socolays, I'm in. So we got a beautiful sunrise in Texas. Wearing a couple of shirts. That's it, man. How can you beat that temperature for mid-December in Texas? Get on down the highway, meet James, and we'll see if Jimmy D can put us on more crappie. Lake Whitney?
Yes, sir. Morning, how are you?
Good. So what are we going to do today, man? We're going to have some fun black and white crappies?
Absolutely. Mostly going to be some white crappie. There will be a couple black ones mixed in. We're going to be, might be a couple roamers. Most of these fish are going to be stuck to some timber out here. So we're going to cover some ground and use that live sonar like we were yesterday and try to put it on some good fish.
Nice stuff. So basically, nice sunrise, early December. This kind of temperature, is it normally get like this?
Yeah, we're right around 33 or 32 down here.
Yeah, it warms up nice in the
afternoon. Yeah, we got some sunlight. We got a little bit of wind. It's going to play into our favor today, I think, with the conditions and stuff. But it's starting off chilly, and usually it makes the fish want to bite a little better. So
okay.
I'm not real mad about it.
How about put the boat in the lake and go out and have some fun, huh?
Let's do it.
Okay.
Yeah, we're out here on the Brazos River up above Lake Whitney, and we're going to be out here chasing some big white crappie. A lot of these fish are just going to be out here glued to some underwater timber. Some of them might be on some little brush piles, but for the most part, these fish are going to have their nose glued right to this timber, and we're going to take these Mr. Crappie jigs, and we're going to drop them down and put them in between their nose and that tree and see if they want to bite.
That's the man, Mr. James. Uh-oh. That's how Jake starts. Well, that's a good fish, dude, huh?
Yes, sir.
Oh, show him how that ate that.
Oh, yeah.
Hold him on the belly like that. Show him how he ate it. Look at that. Hold it for a second. He's got to get up. Wow. Now, that's how you want them to eat it, huh?
It's a good start to the day.
Yeah, man.
That's kind of going to be our main strategy today, unless we see some fish swimming around in open water, and we're going to go after them and see if we can get them to bite as well. We got some cold water temps down 49 degrees. It's kind of the temperature we like it out here. It gets a lot of these fish start migrating up this river, all the striper and shad and white bass and crappie and everything come up here and just kind of have a heyday on all the shad. So we're going to try to do the same thing.
I love seeing a turn like that. Man. Munch it. That's a chunker, huh?
Yeah, that's a good
one.
Yeah,
dude.
He's healthy.
Yeah.
It's a good Brazos River fish right there.
Yeah. But it's actually what, Lake Whitney? That's what they call it?
Yeah, this is Lake Whitney. It's just a, you know, there's the tri lakes. There's Possum Kingdom, there's Granbury, yep. There's Lake Whitney, and they just dam them up to make these three lakes. And this is what we consider the river up here, but you can see they're just up here eating. They're getting ready to start growing eggs, and, you know, they're just fattening up for the wintertime.
Yeah, man, you called it.
Yep.
We made a move from one spot. There was just too many gar, buffalo fish and carp and stuff, but gar everywhere. James said that these crappie just do not like to inhabit an area where there's that much gar. So we made a short move right away, found some trees, found some crappie. We're going to catch them. These crappie, sometimes they just get mobile, just the way it is. I got all the confidence in the world with James. You know, he's been fishing on this lake 200 days a year on all these surrounding lakes, especially in this lake here, part of the river system. And crappie are crappie. 2 days ago, he's here. They're all sitting in those deep trees about 14 feet down, catchable. And this morning, they're just roaming or sitting on the bottom because there's not a lot of fish in the trees.
Oh, yes.
There he is. Oh.
That's a crappie, it's a big one.
Yes. Oh, it's a good one, huh? Oh, finally broke the ice. Uh-oh, look where he's got it. Don't do that. No. I want to see ya. Yeah. I want to show him the bait in his mouth. Don't do that.
Got to give you a little drama.
He's like doing drumming. He's watching you. Well, officially broke the ice, you know. Striper, missed a few fish. We're not going to be snake bit. No, man. We're the Jimmy D. We're going to catch crappies. But look at the back on these Texas fish. I mean, the DNA, the forage, spawning opportunities, it just shows you everything is perfect here. It's like a fish factory. The whole state. It's really good. Fish all across the United States and every place is unique. And now we're getting to experience a Texas experience, basically. So we'll put them in a box, join some of the others. We'll keep going on Lake Whitney with Davis Guide Service. Let's do it. Whew.
Nice job.
Thanks, Crappie. Right on. Look at the backs on these fish, right? Think about it, too. Okay, they're not the big, giant ones of Lake Fork and some areas, but who cares, man? You can't always have the giants and everywhere, the mutants. That's why some lakes are unique. But fishing like this, I can do this any time of the year. And here in mid-December, just having fun being out there, putting that big pole out and seeing the crappie come over and just grab that plastic and then set hook and boat swing them in. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah, we're just kind of cruising along, running the live sonar out 50 foot or so, and just, we got our transducer on the trolling motor, so wherever it looks is kind of where the thing's looking. So just, you know, looking for what is to be a crappie. And right now we got a whole lot of gar in this area and rough fish, carp and stuff, but you got to kind of just zoom in once you see some structure and get a better look at it. And we're looking for something that's not moving. That's usually the crappie stick out pretty good once you've looked at them quite a bit. And most of them will have their nose right up to that tree.
Talk about beautiful surroundings. Look at this place. Sunrise, all the shorelines here. There's trees everywhere on the bottom and all kinds of life. You're seeing carp, gar, shad, crappie, stripers, you name it. This fishery is healthy. And those big, beautiful crappie, it's just gonna take a bit of an effort. We're gonna find them and we're gonna catch them.
But usually the crappie aren't moving, and that's how they really kind of stand out from the other fish. And just up here where we're fishing, there's just a whole lot of life. There's a lot of bait fish, and a lot of the fish migrate up north here to kind of hang out and live throughout the winter time. So that's just kind of our plan for the day, just cruising around and looking for these fish up against these trees.
The one below the other.
Mm-hmm.
There he is. That's the man. Oh yeah. James is on the crappie.
Got one to buy.
Yes, sir. Slowly but surely, eh? Slowly but surely. Wow.
They're pretty spooky this morning, but we got that one to set still, and let's get a jig in front of him.
Now he's in the boat. And alive well for dinner.
Yep. We'll take him.
One thing James and all the guys have showed me, it's really confusing when you're using the different kinds of sonar that actually sees the structure like a X-ray, okay? When you put two baits down there, sometimes it confuses the fish and they get tangled up. You don't know whose bait is who. So we're taking turns. I'm cool with it. If I miss a fish, so be it. It's his turn. He misses a fish, it's my turn. That's just the way it goes right here.
Yeah, he's right there on that tree. Missed. Yeah, he's right there at the top of that tree. There might actually be a couple there.
Got him. That's a man. Is it a netter?
No, sir.
Oh, just a lifter, huh?
Just a lifter.
There you get him.
There we go.
You are the crappie man.
He was just kind of moving around that tree real slow.
Look where he got it too, eh?
Got him a mouthful.
Slowly but surely.
Yes, sir. They're finally starting to set still. They've been roaming around feeding all morning, and so they're kind of starting to get up on these trees, and that's what we need them to do. Set still for just about 4 or 5 seconds. So the technique we use today is, you know, when we would spot a fish on the side of a tree, we'd get our bait, drop it down, get it down as fast as we can, but we want to stop it before we get there. and ease it down to him. And we didn't want to get eye level with him. We wanted to hover it right over his head, maybe wiggle our arm a little bit. And a lot of times they'd see it immediately, but the ones that didn't, we had to give a little vibration. Once we knew he seen it and he looked up at it, we had to take it away. And if you stop, he sniffs it out and he knows that something's not right. So you just got to keep that bait moving. And sometimes it's way high in the water column before he decides to eat it. So that's how these fish have really wanted the baits presented to them. And that's just kind of what we stuck to. And, you know, they would bite them that way.
That's a man. That's a man. James is on his game.
That'll work. Good Brazos River Whitney crappie right there.
I don't know about you, but this opportunity to fish at different lakes all the time, places I've never dropped a jig, and still figuring it out with the guide, show me how he's doing it. It's priceless. It's priceless information. You gotta think about these guides. These guides put so much time and effort in, but they give you the opportunity to come out with them and help you put some meat in the freezer and learn more techniques that are gonna help you on your lakes. Think about the guides. They're your easiest way to learn to catch more and big crappie. How can you not like stripers? A bucket list fish. Every place I've been across the states over the years, I just didn't do it. Other guys are doing it and tell me how much fun it is. There it is. Come here, fish.
Did you hook into a striper?
Or that's just a big crappie. Let's see. What do I got here?
I don't know.
Striper? Look at that thing fighting it.
Yep.
Oh, striper. I shouldn't have said it, huh? I shouldn't have said it. I shouldn't have said it, right?
Told you, they'll come in. And
yeah, man. Get them. You lip these things?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, look how he took it too, eh? Oh, boy. I thought for a sec I got me one of them giant Texas crappie, but he's not.
Striper. He got in the way.
Are they in season?
What's that, as far as taking?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. They're year-round.
Striper. People eat these up, eh?
Absolutely, yeah.
Okay. Wow. Yep. Okay, put them in the box. When you book a charter with James, and if he tells you that he sees the gulls all going over, the birds are everywhere, that the stripers are there, do it. Either use the same crappie baits or change up whatever he's got in the boat, because they are a ball of fun. Yep. What? You nailed it, eh, James? Pull it up fast. Make it look like you're going to pull it away. Oh, my God. This is the biggest crappie I've ever had in my life. Look at that. Look.
It's one of them hybrid girls.
It might even be a bluegill. Look. Man, are they fight tough, huh?
Oh, yeah.
My goodness me. You weren't whistling Dixie. Oh, I'm on the striper show. Oh, yes. Dude, I love all those things. Bite. I see the appeal of stripers. Wow, man. Hold on, buddy. You almost look like a saltwater fish. Hold on. Oh, look how he ate it too. Look down in there. And James, you take a lot of people up for these things, don't you?
Oh, absolutely, yes, sir.
And that's about eating size too?
Yep, that's about a 19-inch fish and just good eating size and they get a lot bigger.
Wow, look how cool they look. I love the little stripers. Ready? You're lucky, buddy. I'm from out of province, so out of country. See ya.
In fact, we actually ran into some bonus fish. It's another fish that I guide for. Is a striped bass, and Carl hadn't really been into those, so we made a little stop and we put a few fish in the boat pretty quickly. So got some drag pulled out. So if that's something that might interest you as well as crappie fishing, you know, you guys can give me a shout at 817-983-8750. You can find me on Instagram. You can find me on Facebook. You can actually find me on TikTok. So if you guys would like to go fishing, book a trip, reach out. I'd love to have you guys out and enjoy some of this fine fishing that Texas has to offer. I can't believe you had never caught a striper.
Nope. I'm addicted to
Jesus,
it now.
Jesus, look at that, man.
Another big crappie?
Big crappie. Oh, look at him go. Oh, I got a big one this time, folks. Oh, yeah.
Well,
you got a double header?
We do. Hey, double header on Whitney. And look at this, folks. Ooh, lordy. Oh, yeah. Even the cameraman doesn't know which one to go to. He's got one here. He's got one there.
Here you go.
How big's yours? Oh, this is fun, man. Honest to goodness, dude. Honest to goodness, this is fun. Ho, ho, ho.
A little bonus fish up here.
Yes, sir. Ain't nothing wrong with this, boy. I love crappies, but when I can get a chance to do this kind of stuff, too, because I ain't never done this before. Look at that. Whew. Little crappie bait catching stripers. When you see a school of fish like that, seriously, even when you come out with James for crappie and you see the stripers and you want some more meat to take home, look at that, man. Look.
It's hard to pass up.
Yeah, man. And it's incredible how good they bite.
Yes.
How can you not like that, man?
Yeah.
Hey?
Can't.
Jigging. You know what's so good about them? They cooperate so good, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Jig. I've never done it before. Almost like walleye fishing to me.
Yeah, oof. Absolutely.
Okay, bye. See ya. In between catching crappie, the stripers. And you know what? I've been a lot of places, just never had the opportunity to catch the stripers. So when they're on the screen like this, how can I say no? Come on. It's between a commercial break. Let us catch some stripers, have some fun. We'll get back on the crappie. But in the meantime, stripers, I'm in. You will too when you see the addiction.
Yeah, I just want to show you guys the baits we are using today. Mr. Crappie, Strike King, the Joker is what we were using, refrigerator white and hotchicken.com. This is mainly the one we used today. And I mean, when they turned up on it, they ate it. You know, the fish were a little tricky today, but something about this color, when they finally got a look at it and they turned up, they were gonna eat it. They weren't gonna hesitate about it. So we had a fish right here on the side of this tree. I dropped down and he missed, or I missed, one or the other, and he swam off. He's about 10 foot from where he was originally. He's just sitting out there in open water. So I'm gonna let him kind of settle in and try to make another drop on him and see if he'll bite again.
That's a man. Jimmy D.
We got one.
On a crappie. Yes, sir. Yes. Boy, definitely have to work on these fish today, huh?
Oh yeah, they're definitely making us work. They're down there, but they're moving around and making us work, that's for sure. It's good eater size fish right there.
I'm not going to call it challenging, but you just got to get that bait as fast as you can down to the fish. When they're not really active like today, you got to get it right down to their face as quick as possible so they can see it. And you think sometimes that they see it, but they don't react. When they react, either swim off or something, you know they saw it. So you got to keep working it and working it until you get it to the right position. Then you see that little orange spot turn, or you feel the rod tip just go, boom, set hook.
Right there, shake it.
Got him.
There you go.
That's decent, too.
It's going to be a good fish.
Oh, nice crappie. Oh, yes, sir. Look at that,
my
folks.
Man.
Hey, how much effort? Woo, look at that. Woo. That ain't no joke. That's the joker. Oh, boy. Wow, these fish are sluggish. James says he's here a couple days ago checking it out. And they just show how crappie move. You got to be able to adapt. If you're not mobile, good luck, man. When the fish are aggressive, that's one thing. When they're not, you got to put it on their head. You just have to be mobile and move. Look at them shoulders on that fish. But when they see the bait, they eat the bait. All right, buddy? Yeah, you try to be elusive. Good luck. All right, in the boxer. Ready, buddy? We're going to make this work. Yes, going to eat them later.
Today they threw us a curveball. A few of the fish starting off were, and most of the ones that were, we would get right up on the tree and these fish would swim off and swim down to the bottom. Later as the day went on, we seen less and less fish, and most of the fish we seen were actually deeper than that. You know, they were 20 to 23 foot deep, and I think a lot of fish were roaming and laying on the bottom today, which really makes it challenging to drop a little small bait into a fish who's stuck to the side of a tree, and you've got to really pinpoint and be accurate to get that bait right on them. So that's what we did. And, you know, a lot of times it took us multiple drops to get down there, get that fish's attention. And, you know, once he finally did, he was committed. He was going to come up and eat it. Got him. Boy, that took a long time. Get that bite. That dad was sound asleep down there. But when he woke up, he got it. He got in there.
I love this kind of fishing, man. It makes it challenging, but it just makes you a better fisherman. You say, how's that? Because you work a bit harder and you work it. So when you have those really good, easy days, you'll appreciate them. And what I appreciate you watching our series on the crappie machine from North Texas or anywhere else, the 52 states that have crappie, we will chase them, we'll catch them, and we'll show you how to do it with some of the best guides and professional fishermen that fish for crappie for a living. We'll see you next week. Fish safe so you can fish for tomorrow.